And hello everybody, I'm Oric with your Fix It Auto, and today I want to be showing you a very simple but important replacement to make. This is a spare tire hoist, which sits underneath the bed of the truck, and this just slips underneath and then holds the tire up. And then you go here with a special tool in order to raise and lower the spare tire. Now these actually very often break. The thing is, there's these rods that seize up on some of these, and then they end up snapping off, or they end up seizing up here. So a lot of people end up cutting these off. When I purchased this truck, it actually did not come with a spare tire, so I actually ended up purchasing a refurbished spare tire rim, and I'll be putting on the same Michelin Defender tires, so that's going to be nice to have. And of course, I'll be sure to link the one that I use specifically down in the description below, and I'll be sure to also give you guys live updates as to whether or not this fails on me, and I'll be giving those live updates down in the comments section down below. So without further ado, let's get down to it. So you can easily access the spare tire hoist from underneath the car. It's just going to be right here. And as you can see here, mine just snapped off, or it was cut off. It's actually kind of hard to tell. And to give you guys a better view as to what we're gonna be doing, this just hooks on and then it's just tied down with one 15 millimeter bolt. And so with a 15 millimeter socket, ratchet, and extension, I'll just be loosening this up. Let's see how tight this is. Oh, well, that's actually kind of surprising. It's very loose. All right. At least the bolt is not seized. Then we'll just remove the bolt, and the hoist should come right out. So here is the old, I'm assuming the OEM part for this truck. There are a few differences in cosmetics. This one's actually a little bit thicker. One thing that is important to check is just to make sure that it does have the same mounting hole and then that it should be able to hook on. So I'll be testing that out as I'm installing it. But I guess the most important part is to make sure that your spare tire tool will fit on there, which, perfect fit. You can get it up and down by hand. Smooth like butter. But this is pretty much good to go, and I'll be putting it on. So now installation is just the reverse process. So we'll start by hooking this in. The bolt hole lines up. And then I'll start threading this by hand first to avoid cross threading. And then tighten it the rest of the way with a socket and ratchet. And you simply just want to make sure this is nice and good and tight. There are no torque specs that I was able to find personally, but as long as it's nice and tight, we should be good. Nice and firm and good to go. And to show you guys exactly how it works, you just pop this little cover open, stick your key in, and remove this little cylinder. It's actually really hard to show you guys. You should be able to see where the spare tire tool connects to. And then you just grab two of these pieces, connect it together, push this little tab so that way it can slip through and lock, just like that. Then you just feed this through, connect it, and then turn it counterclockwise in order to loosen it up. And that's all there is to it. If for some reason in the future it actually becomes very difficult in order to turn it, it's not as smooth as to be able to turn it by hand, you could also grab this tool right over here, and it has a little square slot where you could slip this part through, and then that'll give you enough torque to be able to actually turn this. And that's really all there is to it. If you liked the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I've got some exciting news on my current projects so that way you guys can see. The 68 Camaro, I ordered the entire front subframe. It'll come with coilovers, tubular arms, and everything that should be here sometime later this month. And then when I get that mounted, that means I can start assembling the entire Camaro. But it's going to be so nice to have a fully assembled Camaro in my driveway. It's something I've always dreamed of. So stay tuned for that. Thank you guys for subscribing and staying with me this long. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section down below. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching.